here, I guess it's good to come after the Chinese presenters, my colleagues, because they said that Chinese was hard and they had the chart and they showed Arabic too was hard.
Yes.
So we fall in that category. And my goal, you know, when I teach Arabic is to try and convince the students, no, Arabic is not hard, it's doable, it's fun. So I've been teaching Arabic for years and years, and at first, of course, the chalkboard was my friend, and you know, VHS videos and so on, and then by and by start to do, you know, more innovative things. And the last couple of years I've been experimenting with using VoiceThread, and last year, you know, Chris and all our wonderful IT team here in Brimore tried to help me use VoiceThread. And what I would do last year through a pilot project we had was to send, you know, videos that I would find on the internet, like from Al Jazeera and so on, things that I thought complemented our textbook, and then they'll capture it for me, they'll put it on VoiceThread, and then I'll have the students, you know, look at it and comment on it. And my idea was, like, it's a VoiceThread, so it's nice that they all share and comment on each other's work. But then that was sort of hard. That was for second year students, and VoiceThread was not built into Moodle. And then this year, because I teach, our program is BICO, so I'm both here and at Haverford College. So the Haverford Moodle this year, and I'll campaign with Chris after my presentation. Please, please, we need Moodle to have VoiceThread built into it. So when VoiceThread is into Moodle, then the students don't have to do anything extra, and you as an instructor, you don't have to do anything extra. You can take your assignments that you already had, and you know, just have the students share them on Moodle. Because, like, at the beginning, for example, when I had, I used to do a family presentation, the students take about 6 weeks at the beginning of first year to learn the alphabet, and so it's not 2 semesters or 2 years like you guys do, it's just one, you know, intensive 6 weeks, and they can read and write, and they have a vocabulary of about 150 words by that time. So I usually had them do a family presentation. I do have here the handouts at the end of, if you would like to get them. But like I have on the back of the handout, the, you know, words for father, mother, grandfather, and maternal and paternal uncles and aunts and so on. I have them for them, and then they're supposed to go out and do a presentation. That so at first they used to do it in class, and then last year I had them do it as a PowerPoint, and then this year I tried and through VoiceThread. And the good thing about that, even though you can, you know, in discussion you can say like no, but it loses the interactive part, is, you know, they already have uploaded their presentation to VoiceThread. They come to class and they each click on it, and then they each, you know, learn about each other through pictures and so on. And then, you know, so, and it's the same, creating a community, creating interaction. By the end of the semester, I used to have them do a video project at the end of first year. And in past years, I would call Chris and say, how would they share the video with me? It's so big, and Moodle doesn't take those big videos, and they'll have to use YouTube, and that was a hassle for some of them. So again, with Moodle and VoiceThread being built into Moodle, they were able to upload their videos immediately here. So if you like, I can show you one that's sort of funny. She built on the book has a story, like there's a video component to our textbook. And there is a character, Maha, who lives in New York. If anybody here teaches Arabic? Oh, okay.
I know, I took Arabic.
Okay.
Maha.
So you know about Maha.
Lonely
how lonely she is, exactly. So see what the students did. The student did, if it works for us here, and how can we get it to work?
I'll click on the arrow in the middle of the page.
This one?
No. Do your...
No, no, I know, to make it big.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Okay, let's Hopefully this will make it big. Okay. So this is Lonely Maha, and so here she say, I do not like New York, I feel lonely, just sitting in her room. And this is her name, Maha, again, on the outside of her dorm room, and she's writing her memoirs, or?
It's me, Maha.
She's saying, my name is Maha, so I can clearly hear her pronunciation. I live in New York. I do not like New York.
while istiha.
And she's taking this from the book, but
wow,
she's building upon.
Ashajara.
So here she's saying, I don't like trees, I don't like
grass.
She feels lonely. She has no friends. And then here's her friends, and she's sitting upset. Again, from the book, it says her parents are always busy. So the parents are trying to get her to go with them to the movies, to stay with her, and she's refusing everything. So she's saying, I don't like my life, but the weather is nice, and then it's raining outside. So, you know, like, this is an extreme case of creativity, of course, but at the same time, you know, I thought, you know, without voice thread and Moodle, you know, it wasn't So that was the end of first year, and then they came back, and students, oh, this is my voice commanding, I don't like to hear my voice. Okay, so here I'm saying this is supposed to be a three people project, so she is... So here I'm just giving them greetings and goodbye and so on, because it was the end of the semester, and my goal was for all of them to watch it and, you know, comment on each other, but of course that really didn't happen, and it was the end of the semester, and who watches, you know, classwork during spring, Christmas break anyway? And then come this semester, so the 17 of the 20 students came back, and hopefully this is the right one. Yeah. And so I used Moodle again, and again, another feature that I like in this Moodle is it has attendance, and attendance builds nicely into the great book. So please, attendance, Chris. So again, towards the end of the, we did several projects, and one time I took them to the computer lab, and they worked there, and then towards the end of the semester, a few weeks ago, I gave them, again, their, you know, the sheet for the assignment, and then they did a book project. I used to also do a book project before. In the early 2000s, I used to have the students illustrate the book with their own hands, and then by and by, I used a website called Zooverse that a friend of mine had developed, but that had its own problems. And then this year was the first time I tried again to have them submit their projects through VoiceThread. And the good thing is, you know, like once the students submit the project and agree that you can see it. And what I learned from this particular project, now that the semester, you know, I'm not done submitting my grades, but I'm thinking like who deserves what in each project and so on, is like if I do this next year again, and I hope I would, I should like have a rubric, something that I've never had before, because like, for example, some of them did everything that was required in the assignment. Some of them just did the voice recording, which I assumed, of course, there is a text they're reading from. And some of them put the text but didn't do the recording, and I had to hunt them down, even though after finals were not supposed to be after the students, but like it's like, oh, somehow there is a technical problem, and could you please you know, make sure that your recording is there. And then just to show that I could also do VoiceThread, here when you do add your own, you can create your own. So I put a couple, and I wonder if they'll watch them over the summer, because some of them are returning next year to take second year. So I guess that's basically what I want to share. So if you have questions, or we can wait for the questions at the end, and then maybe during question answer, I could you know, think of things. But is there, you know, I don't, you know, these are all in Arabic, so I don't want to just, you know, torment you by having you watch them. But how many of you have used VoiceThread out of curiosity? Okay, so you are familiar with it, and now it's pros and cons. Okay, and Maha's friend in the room.
I was just going to ask, because my experience as a student, there were a lot of sounds in Arabic that aren't, that do not have corollary in English.
Right.
So like klein, I still can't do it. My professor told me to act like I was puking.
Aww.
So so with that, did this help you assess like their growth in pronunciation?
Definitely, yeah. The good thing is, like, I can't say like this by itself helped me assess, because the textbook comes with, of course, the DVDs, but also the third edition, which I don't use in the classroom, but it has a website, and I do make them use the website.
Mm-hmm.
So the website has features that are similar to this, where they have to record their own voice. So they are already, you know, used to typing, they're used to recording their own voice. So VoiceThread is not really that alien, even though at first it seems like, oh my god, you know, this is a new, you know, and as was said in the presentation previous to that, in the previous hour, you know, we assume students are very familiar with technology, but some of them it's like, no, this is for my own personal fun, I don't want you to bring it into the, you know, the classroom too. But the website does have, and the website is very interactive, and they love that, you know, so, so they already know that before, you know, in the first 6 weeks when they're learning the letters, mm-hmm. and they're learning how to read and write and pronounce and so on, the website is a big help now. And then also in class, like, this is an intensive course, so we're every day having them pronounce. And some people believe that you don't have to have perfect pronunciation from the beginning, but I like to use these first 6 weeks to really perfect the way. Yeah. Which letter do you have difficulty with?
I still do, the klein.
Oh, the rain. But see,
yeah,
the rain is the first letter that all babies at 6 months say, and we can all say it. Say rain. Good job. So, so we do lots. Rain is very difficult when it comes with the ra, because
right.
it's like French L plus Arab, English R. So those drive anybody crazy at the beginning. But we're very patient at the beginning, and you know, by the time they do their very first family presentation, actually, most of them are fine. Like, of course, watching these, I could tell, you know, who, you know, even without reading the names, I could tell, oh, you know, the lengths of the, you know, some people write in paragraphs, some write in, you know, still in, you know, sentences, and the way they pronounce, or the way they make mistakes, and remember the idafa, the possession, you know, possession has a certain way of saying it, so you can definitely tell. So this becomes sort of a reaffirmation for me more than you know, you guys are doing with the Chinese. Yeah.
Shukran.
Okay, shukran. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much.